Yesterday we looked at how the first Quran was compiled under the Abu Bakr, and then we looked at how the second Quran and their reasoning to be compiled under the Abu Bakr, because oral tradition was failing. And then we looked at the Islamic sources where we read that soon after the first second Quran has been compiled, all the Quranic manuscripts and written version of the Quran is been burned. And I don't know what happened, but along the way, something happened that today I end up having 37 different Arabic Qurans. I was quite happy with one, but God does make miracles, so I end up having 37 different Arabic Qurans. What I'm gonna do is tonight I will be just looking at, according to Islamic tradition, history is very, very different. We will be looking at the history. According to Islamic tradition, how the 37, not 37 actually, more than one Quran appeared in Islamic world. So, let me, I don't think I'm gonna show, I'm gonna like simply read Sahih Bukhari. And then after that, I will be reading, just summarizing some of this book. Both of them are written by, put together by devoted Muslims. I didn't do it. I don't even have time to do so, but I've got time to read them. It's called Sharing is Caring. So first I'm going to go to Sahih Bukhari, and then where we are going to see how the idea of more than one Quran has been introduced. We will be looking at the reason of that, and then we are going to try to figure out actually what happened. What happened that Uthman decided to get rid of the different Qurans. And then we will have the next session on the follow-up of lots of different things. I've got like lots of materials. And now, because we are going to get back to Speaker's Corner, that means life is back to normal. Therefore, I have to find the time to do live stream on those Qurans before we get back to Cornell. I was going to even introduce you to God of Surah 53, the one I met back in March. I haven't even got it time to do so, but we will, by God's grace, we will get there. So, let me... So this is simply copy and paste of Muslim sources. If anyone is doubting my copy and paste skill, I've got book here. I can simply read the book for you. But since they were like in my slides long time before. So I am just simply gonna read it from the already copied paste version. But as I said, if any Muslim wants to question my copy and paste skills, we can deal with that. So until the event which I'm going to read it to you takes place, none of the Muslims are aware there is more than one Quran, more than one version of the Quran out there. There is no one is aware of that, okay? And we go to Sahih Bukhari, volume 6. Book 61, hadith number 514. And then you can read it also from 561. And then also you can read the same story from Muwatta. But I'm going to read the Sahih Bukhari version for you. Please, please do follow and read with me. Narrated by Umar bin Khattab. So he's the second caliph, Muhammad's father-in-law. I heard Hisham bin Hakim reciting Surah Al-Furqan. That's Surah 25. Umar is hearing, Hisham is reciting Surah 25 during the lifetime of Muhammad. And I listened to his recitation and noticed that he recited in several different ways, which Allah's apostle had not taught me. Second caliph is saying, I am hearing Hisham is reciting Surah 25, but it is very, very different than what Muhammad taught me. And remember, this is the Umar who has power over heavenly beings, who is the father-in-law of Muhammad, and he's the one who caused three verses to end up in the Quran. Without him, Allah wouldn't put those verses in the Quran. So he hears that Surah 25 has been recited differently. I was about to jump over him during his prayer. The way it's been recited is causing Umar to have different feelings. He wants to jump over Hisham, and he wants to do that during his prayer. But I controlled my temper. And when he had completed his prayer, I put his upper garment around his neck and seized him by it. You can imagine this scene, okay? That is like, he's about to hang him. That's that image. I put his upper garment around his neck and seized him by it and said, who taught you this surah which I heard you are reciting? He replied, Allah's apostle taught me. I said, you have told a lie, for Allah's apostle has taught it to me in a different way from yours. I know this surah. This is Surah 25. This is Surah Furqan. I learned it from Muhammad as well. But the way you are reciting is wrong. Therefore, if Muhammad teach you different, teach me different. Muhammad will never do such a thing. Therefore, I am just assuming you are lying, but we are going to figure that out. Okay? He replied, Allah's apostle taught it to me. I said, you have told a lie, for Allah's apostle has taught it to me in a different way from yours. So I dragged him to Allah's apostle and said to Muhammad, I heard this person is reciting Surah 25 in a way which you haven't taught me. On that, Allah's apostle said, release him, O Umar. Recite, O Hisham. Then he recited in the same way as I heard him in reciting. Then Allah's apostle said, it was revealed in this way, and added, recite, Umar. I recited as he had taught me. Allah's apostle said then said, it was revealed in this way. This Quran has been revealed to be recited in seven different ways. So, recite of it whichever way easier for you. Umar is hearing Surah 25 is being recited differently. Umar is hearing Surah 25 is being recited differently. It is different, which causing not Umar to only go and grab him and then put his upper garment on him, but also causing him to call Hisham a liar. Because Umar knows if there was a different version of the Quran, he would know, because Allah would use Muhammad to tell him the different versions of the Quran. By this time, no one is aware. Actually, there are different versions of the Quran. It seems Umar is just figuring out that by accident. And from that, both of them goes to Muhammad. Both of them recite the surah. And then Muhammad simply says, it is revealed in both ways. So the two chapters are different, being recited differently. And they're not like just my pronunciation versus pronunciation of Phil or Fred. That differences was causing Umar to call another Muslim liar. He was nearly about to attack him when he was praying, but he practiced self-control and waited him to finish his prayer. And then all he gets from Muhammad is, yep, they are revealed in both ways. Does anyone have any suspicion of what's happening? Why no one knows? Even the Umar, who heavenly beings are freaks out from Umar, even Umar doesn't know. Quran has been revealing in different ways. People are reciting different versions of the Quran. Sadly, Muhammad didn't even bother to tell that to anyone until people are about to fight with one another. And then what Muhammad says is, yep, it's okay, it's been revealed in that two different ways. So I'm gonna come to that one, continue my story, but before I'm very behind, getting behind of the chat, let me just simply respond to, there is apparently hilarious comment in here. What about the many, many Bibles? King James Version, New International Version. I don't know what version. They're translations. English translation of the Bible. For those of you who doesn't know, King James Version is old English. I find difficult to read it because of my English, but I did read it. And NIV is another English translation. None of them gives me different story. So if Shabir Ali is making such a claim, I'm afraid to tell him that he's been Islamic scholar for years just as a waste of his time. That is just sad. That is just sad. The issue happening between Umar and Hisham is, Umar is calling Hisham a liar because the way he's reciting and because the way he's praying. So that means when, okay, I'm gonna pick the first name, Debit, in the chat, is reading the King James Version of the Bible. If he's reading that King James Version of the Bible and he's telling me, oh, according to this, Jesus didn't die. And then you come to NIV, and then according to NIV, Jesus died. That is the issue happening in the Quran. Sadly, don't be surprised, anyone. There is not such a thing between King James and NIV version of the Bibles. They are just the translations for the different level of the English language expressed. I am aware that people who's got very, very good English, they are like, they love to read King James Version because they enjoy the language. But what's happening in Sahih Bukhari is no one is knowing about. There are different versions of the surahs out there. And that's not enough. It's not only apparently one or two versions, but it is 7 different versions. One of the practical issues is actually, if you think about it, Umar said the second caliph, man who is identified as the bloody caliph, as well as father-in-law of Muhammad, as well as man who has power over heavenly beings, and the one who contributes to the word of Allah. And this poor guy Hisham, who's simply just trying to practice Islam and recites a different version of the Surah 25, they are from the same people group. Okay? So if you think very practically, think a village that everyone is originally from that village. They were born in that village, they lived in that village, they learned everything in that village, they speak all exactly the same sound. Okay? But what Allah does is apparently, Allah decides to give them 7 different versions of the one surah. And one of the miracle thing is, we don't know what is the version Ibn Hisham was reciting. Or we don't know what is the version Umar was reciting. Because this 1924 officialized, 10th July 1924, and later same year, and then with the adjustment 1936, officialized Quran has only one version of Surah 25. But at 7th century, there were two different versions of Surah 25. Of course, if Umar has one version, Hisham has one version, then my basic question is, since the Quran is identified as the eternal word of Allah, it is on eternal tablets of Allah, in the tablet of heaven, which version is there? Which version? Umar's versions, Hisham's versions, or this one's? We don't know. And another sad reality is only the correct version is going to intercede for those who recite it. Let's hope with the good heart that actually it is not the version of Umar or Hashim, which kind of, we don't know, or this one. Let's hope it's this one. Because that's the one Muslims are reciting. That's the one is going to intercede for you. If, of course, if it is this one. It's not only there is a big fight between Umar and Hisham regarding the different Qurans, but also someone who is identified as the very, very godly man, according to Islam, one of the Sahabais of Islam, Muslims, Muhammad, sorry. And he is also the one where Muslim needs to take the Quran from, Ubay bin Ka'b, questions his faith regarding the different versions of the surahs. Please, read with me. Ubay bin Ka'b reported. Ubay bin Ka'b is a good guy. Okay? Muhammad trusted him and then told people to take the Quranic verses from this guy. Ubay bin Ka'b reported. I was in the mosque, when a man entered and prayed and recited the Quran in a style to which I objected. Seems very similar stories. Then the another man entered the mosque and recited in a style which different from that of his companion. When we had finished the prayer, we all went to Allah's messenger and then said to him. Now there are three people are going to Muhammad and tell Muhammad. Oh lovely Muhammad, we are in need of help because we messed up. Let's see what they are going to say to Muhammad. When we had finished the prayer, we all went to Allah's messenger and then said to him, this man recited in a style to which I objected. And the other entered and recited in a style different from that of his companion. The messenger of Allah asked them to recite, and so they recited. And Allah's apostle expressed approval of their affair, the way they recite the Quran, and that occurred in my mind, a sort of denial which did not occur even during the day of ignorance. There are three different Qurans being recited. Both of them are in front of Muhammad. Muhammad says okay to those different Quran, different versions. And then Ubay bin Ka'ab says, in my mind, I had a sort of denial, which didn't even happen before Islam. When the Messenger of Allah saw how I was affected, when he says how I was affected, that was like how he was affected by Muhammad to give approval for those different versions of the Quran, he struck my chest, whereupon I broke into sweating. He simply got beaten. Because Muhammad noticed, yep, Ubay bin Ka'ab's not noticed I was lying. And felt as though I were looking at Allah with fear. Muhammad said to me, Ubay, a message was sent to me to recite the Quran in one dialect. And I replied, make it easy for my people. It was conveyed to me for the second time that I should recite it two dialects. Again, I replied to him, make it easy for my people. It was went on. And at the end, what happens? It's just so sad. Like, at the end, third time to recite in seven dialects. And you've got a seeking for every reply that I send you, which you should seek from me. I said, oh Allah, forgive my people. And I have deferred the third time, one for the day on which the entire creation will turn to me, including even Abraham for intercession. Ubay bin Ka'ab, whom Muhammad tells the Quran, take the Quran from, doesn't even know there are different versions of the Quran are being told. Qurans are being told to the people. When he sees Muhammad says okay to those different Qurans, he doubts. He's in denial. When Muhammad notices, oh, I got caught, he strike Ubay bin Ka'b in his chest, which caused him into sweating. Of course, you should be all very easy to understand that because it is not be suddenly it become hot. It become painful. And then Muhammad, of course, explains, but until that time, Ubay bin Ka'b is the where whom people are going to take the Quran from. Ubay bin Ka'b is not even been told, yeah, just beware. You are going to pass the Quran from generation to generation, from people to people, from tribe to tribe. Quran is being revealed to me in seven different ways. What is the reason? Because Allah wanted to give it to one way. I was so good. I knew. I can't read and write. My knowledge when it comes to the basic is like very, very little. And then I thought, oh, that is the same for Muslim community. That is the same for my people. They are not good enough to memorize one version. What I'm gonna do? I'm gonna make it easy. Ask for a couple of different versions. Allah, He's so generous. He's so generous. He gives seven different versions of the Quran. That's what it's called generosity. People can't memorize the one version. What you do is you make it easy. You give them seven different versions. I think it's hilarious. Of course, Umar didn't know about it. Ubay bin Ka'b doesn't know about it. Muhammad just giving birth to different Qurans. And Umar or Ubay bin Ka'b, whoever first event took place, none of them is like telling others, actually, this is what has been happening. Just sad, sad, sad reality. So, why do you think suddenly Quran comes in seven different ways? Why suddenly people start hearing, oh yeah, there are different versions of the Quran, which Muhammad didn't even tell anyone. And then why do you think Allah suddenly steps in and then says, oh, I came to rescue Muhammad. I'm gonna give seven different versions. Because Muhammad asked for it. When Muhammad asked to reduce the daily prayer, Muhammad had to go up and down, go and go up and down. He probably lost lots of weight on the way to heaven. And thanks to Moses, he got the prayer reduced. But when it comes to the Quranic, different Qurans, different versions of the surahs, Allah is just like, sure, your people can't. They are stupid people. They wouldn't be able to recite the one version. What we will do is, let me give you two versions. Muhammad says, oh no, still we can't do it. Remember, my people are just stupid. They wouldn't even know how to say one plus one. And then Allah says, oh, if they can't say one version, let's make it seven version. So it will all messed up. It will all mess up. And when the moment Ubay bin Ka'b recognized this, there is like something is not right. Muhammad's memory must be very horrible. He doesn't even remember how he makes up those verses. He just remembers little bit of one version, little bit of one version. And then everyone remembers what he said to them, and there are different versions. And from that, Ubay bin Ka'b is having trust issues. And he says, that wasn't even happening before Islam. Let me just look at the chat and then see if I have got any comments on for those two stories. First of all, my first question is, why for one people group there are different versions of the chapters are being revealed? My second question is, why no one is telling anyone? until people start fighting with one another. My third question is, again, Allah comes to rescue. What does it say to you about Allah and His word? I'm trying to see if there is any. Wow, this is the best response I think we have. Unless I missed anything. People are fighting with one another. People are calling one another liar. People are getting beaten at the time of Muhammad because there are the different versions of the Quranic text. And I am assuming this person is Muslim. It's simply attacking Christian scripture, which the scripture Allah is falling in love. That's the scripture Muhammad is falling in love. Yet today's Muslims are no have to guard their heart. Their heart is against Allah's heart. Their heart is against Muhammad's heart. That's what happens. I think wonderful, wonderful. Yes, can I get some help from those of you who are in chat? I can't see how many of you, but I am assuming there are some people because there are lots of comments are just going down. What's happening? No, it doesn't prove that recitation or memorization or any form of that is in, it's fragile. No, it tells us it's messed up. You cannot trust it. It is messed up. Even it messed up at the time of Muhammad in front of his presence. And he was all okay and was just like nodding when he heard different Qurans. And side information, that happens apparently in Medina. That means there shouldn't be any different versions of the surahs in Mecca verses. But in the future, when we look at the different, with the textual variations, all those kind of things, we will see actually Mecca and Medina verses. They all messed up. They all messed up. That's like so beautiful, I think. Just amazing miracle of Islam. I'm trying to get proper response for my basic questions. I don't want to break your heart, but I have read the Qurans. It's not the Quran, it's the Qurans. I have read them. And I am disappointed it seems you never read it. If you read it, your brains would be working. Can I get simply answer to my questions? Let me repeat my question. Why no one else is no, why doesn't anyone know? Even Umar, who even the heavenly beings are freaked out by him. Umar is the one who contributes to the eternal word of Allah. He doesn't even know that the verses, the chapters of the Quran is appearing in different versions. That he's calling another Muslim liar. And then he wants to grab him while he's praying. But Good self-control, good self-control. While Allah ask for self-control, Muhammed prays, Allah prays for self-control. Umar has better self-control than Allah. How come no one knows there are the different versions of the Quran? How come Ut Ubay bin Ka'b, whom Muhammad tells people to take the Quran from, doesn't even know that there are different versions of the verses? We don't know which version he passed. And when he hears, Muhammad simply nods his head and affirms the different versions of the surahs. It causes him to have a doubt in his faith. And that's just like within the time of Muhammad. This is before sheep came and then eat the verses. This is before people died in the Battle of Yamama, that Quran has been lost. This is before Uthman burned the Qurans. This is before Al-Hajjaj destroyed the Qurans. This is before Cairo University sunk the Quran in the river. Before that all, long, long, long time ago, once upon a time, people in the presence of Muhammad were fighting with one another with the different versions of the Quranic surahs. That is what we call miracle of Islam. I meant to say Umar. Probably my pronunciation is not very correct. So Umar is the second caliph of Islam and father-in-law of Muhammad. According to Islamic tradition, even Satan changes his way when Umar walks on the road, when Satan saws Umar. Muhammad has Satan and his own devil, but heavenly beings are afraid of Umar that they change their direction. We did live stream on this last week, I think. And there are some non-English comments down in the chat. I'm just asking this question in with full of generous heart. I can see there are Muslims in the chat. Are you being paid to come in this chat and then just talk about the things which doesn't even we are discussing? If that is the case, I am afraid you are in wrong channel. And sad, sad, sad. Sad, sad, sad. I don't have. Muslims don't even want to defend their Quran. That is the Quran you are going to. It's going to intercede for you. Better to learn how to defend the Quran. Muslims claim that Muhammad did not order the verse to be written down. How come the entire surah about sucking and stoning was written down only to be eaten by sheep? I don't think that's correct, because we know Zaid bin Thabit was in the time of Abu Bakr, there were the verses were written down. Zaid bin Thabit's job was to write the revelation of Allah down according to the Islamic tradition. So it's not only the verses of adult breast suckling and stoning was eaten. There are chapters were missing. There are approximate 400 verses are missing. Surah 33 is supposed to be as long as Surah 9, but it is not like that. Surah 9 supposed to be as long as Surah 2. It is not like that. So it has been butchered, not only by sheep, but even by Muslims. So I would challenge the claim that Revelation was not written down at the time of Muhammad, because people were writing the Revelation down. Okay, so since I've got seriously heartbreaking response from people regarding the how Muhammad is giving birth twice to different Arabic Qurans, not only one occasion, but it happens twice. In one of them is grab the guy who is reciting the different version. In the second one, Ubay bin Ka'b gets beaten by Muhammad, because Ubay bin Ka'b noticed, yep, this guy is messed up. But let me come back to another lovely explanation. I'm not even gonna talk about how actually Muhammad forgotten prayers, forgotten Quranic verses, all those kind of things. But I'm just gonna come to the story. Why Allah, with all of his wisdom, give the Quran in more than different ways? I'm gonna read it from this book. I kind of post the here's the part I'm gonna read it. This is, I think it was page 172 to 173 of the book, okay? This is by Yasir Kadim. He's like well-known Muslim scholar. Actually, if you listen to some of his lectures, you would say, yeah, he's a clever guy. So, what he tells us is, why do we have different Qurans? Why did people have different Qurans at the time of Muhammad, but Muhammad never bothered to tell anyone? So, Gabriel recited the Quran to me in one half, and I recited back to him, but I request him to increase, and he continued to increase for me until we stopped at 7 Ahruf. So there is like one version, okay? Everyone should be able to know. It's like very simple. Everyone recites the same thing. That seems very simple. But what Muhammad does is, I request angel to increase for me. He's gonna mess up. Like, I think this is like very bad move. But anyway, Gabriel came to him and then said, Allah has commanded you to recite the Quran to you, your people, in one way. Okay? The Prophet replied, I ask Allah's pardon and forgiveness. My people are not capable to do this. If we are reciting the Quran, if we are learning the Quran, if we are practicing the Quran in one way, That's everyone is like gonna say the same thing. My people are not capable to do so. Gabriel came back again and then said, Allah has commanded you to recite the Quran to your people in two ways. And then that happens a couple of times. Allah has commanded you to recite the Quran to your people in seven ways. And in whichever way they recite, they would be right. So there is a word, I'm sure you can see on the screen, it says Ahruf. That is the our miracle. That is miracle word, okay? No one knows what is Ahruf, only Allah knows. According to Yasir Kadi. No one knows what is Ahruf, only Allah knows. Whatever it was, Allah give it to in seven different ways. So whatever that Ahruf is, Allah gives seven different Ahruf. So I'm guessing this is where my kind of logic fails. Okay? So, if someone fails to learn something in one version, okay, why would you introduce the second version of that thing? Why would you introduce the third version of that thing? Why would you introduce the fourth version of that thing? Why would you introduce the fifth version of that thing? And sixth and seventh? Because as the number gets bigger, as you've got lots of different versions, it makes it more difficult to memorize. But Allah and Muhammad didn't think about that. They thought, oh yeah, let's give seven different ways and it will be all easy for people. I don't know, we do have lots of different translations of the Bible. There are only few people who memorize like 10, 9 different translations, but ideally you want to memorize one verse from one translation, because unless like you've got amazing mind, otherwise it will just messed up. But what happens is Muhammad and Allah thinks, yep, people are not capable to learn in one way. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do it in seven different ways. Remember, reason is people are not capable. Muhammad doesn't even trust his people. That's so sad. And then from that, what happens is, whatever those seven different ways is, okay, what Uthman does to those different ways? He decides, no, they are going to come down to one, and he brings them to one way. And he orders everything to be burned. He orders everything to be burned. That's just a miracle. That is just a miracle. Look, I think we've got someone who just figured out the answer to this basic question. Why Muhammad is not telling anyone? Quran is already being revealed in different ways. People are memorizing in different ways. It's not, of course, I forgot it. It's just like, this is how Allah give it to. Until people start fighting with one another. Until Ubay bin Ka'ab is doubting his faith. Because that was holy sheep. Holy sheep ate the Quranic verses and then it's gone. And then Aisha complained about the verses. Umar complained about verses to not be there. But it's all gone. It's all gone. And we do have four pages of Sahih Muslim talks about those verses. And in those four pages of Sahih Muslim and other hadiths, of course, gives us the version of the stories how it end up being in different ways. Why Surah 355 is different than in English translation than Turkish and Arabic? Which version should follow to obey Allah? Arabic version. Essential principles is don't ever trust the Turkish translation. I can't remember which surah is, but which verse is. One of the surah 85 verse 22 is only in English translation. And there you can check that with your Turkish translation of the Quran. Surah 85 verse 22. When I first find this out, I was like so disappointed. So Surah 25 verse 22 is only 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 words in English. Okay? It is, I think it is 40 words in Turkish translation. Like it's almost paragraph just telling you what is Surah 85 verse 22. So they put the tafsir in it, but they didn't even explain that's the tafsir, or they didn't even put the parentheses or anything. So that's just a disappointing, but don't be surprised. Don't be surprised with this all. I think those are my questions from tonight. But I'm not getting any answer to my questions, and I don't know why. I really don't know why. How many people were in Mecca in 7th century that they would have 7 dialects? This is a sign that Muhammad. So people. Umar and Hisham, so those people are from one they're from one people group, so they've got only one dialect, but still Allah kind of thinks, yeah, let me mess them up. They can memorize one version, I'm gonna give them 7 version. Muslim scholars try to come up with what this 7 version is, but Yasir Kadri gives us some options. Couple of options, and then at the end he says, actually, it is only Allah knows what it is. But whatever it was, Uthman ordered all the things to be burned. And then Uthman made it only one way. So while Muhammad is begging Allah, while Muhammad is begging Allah to, oh, my people cannot memorize this. My people cannot do this. They're just like not clever enough. Uthman says, oops, no, we are gonna put it in one way. We are gonna put it in one way. So I'm very much behind of the comments. I'm just gonna go towards end to see what's happening at the end. Because we are gonna finish the evening, and then we will pick this up with looking at how Muslims are confirming today. Yes, there are different Arabic Qurans, and then they are giving us the English translations of these Arabic Qurans. So we will be looking at them in next time when we meet on this topic. I am amazed with the knowledge of Allah. Allah, who is like very, 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 has a very disappointing mind. His knowledge is very, very bad. But he still knows best. H2O is Arabic expert and professor. Then he can tell us what happened to those Qurans revealed to Muhammad. What did Uthman did? As a professor, can he tell us, please, how can Uthman had a right to burn all the Qurans? How come Muhammad never even bothered to tell his close friends that his close friends that actually Quran has been in lots of different ways. Just go as you like. How come Muhammad beats his friend whom people needs to take the Quran from? That because he sees there is a doubt. Yes, but there are not much things there because we all know Shabir Ali a couple of years ago expressed that he doesn't care about different Qurans or manuscripts. All he cares about number 19 of miracle number 19 from 1924 Quran, and that's all recorded public. I can show them from my Qurans as well as I can show them from the Muslim translations of the Quran. That is gonna be on Sunday. That is gonna be on Sunday, not Sunday actually, in our next episode, but I don't even need to show you that because there is already lots of videos up on DCCR Ministries YouTube channel as well as Fanda Films YouTube channel where you can go and see them. Since you are Arabic expert and professor, I am sure you should be able to recognize those differences and then give us some explanation and then tell us which one is in the eternal tablets of Allah. Kindly please first watch those videos and then come back with proper and useful and useful and useful rebuttal. So, sad to see, Muslims are still hiding behind the things and they're not responding any of the Muslim scholars. And another reliable Muslim scholars that this guy, as they simply tells us that, as they simply tells us how Quran has been corrupted and how Muhammad produced different and different Qurans. Those were my simple questions I did ask, and I am disappointed once again that Muslims have no answer, but we will be asking the same questions until we get proper answer. Even though Allah has two right hand, Allah does not use his brain to answer the basic questions or share the basic informations. That was just a side comment to someone who just put down that Allah has two right hands. And remember, Allah has a womb as well. But with all that in mind, with my lovely questions, let me just tell you something so amazing and so wonderful and so delightful. That is Lord Jesus Christ, the eternal Word of God. We don't have seven version of him. We've got only one version of God, man. That is awesome, amazing, and wonderful. And Lord Jesus Christ is the one who stepped into the world, didn't turn up as a king, didn't turn up as a warrior, didn't turn up as a child abuser. He turned up as a baby, lived among us, ran behind the people who were running away from God, met with them where they were at. And he laid his life down on the cross for us. He did not stay dead. He's alive. He rules and reigns. He's on the throne today. And with his death and his resurrection, this perfect word of God offers his heart to humanity. If you are watching tonight and you shouldn't, none of you needs to be genius or Einstein to figure out eternal word of Allah has been corrupted, and there are intentional deceiving when it comes to the eternal word of Allah. But eternal word of God, Lord Jesus Christ, he's perfect. He's delightful, he's generous, and he's awesome. That's not only enough, he is our savior. He can be your savior as well. For that, all you've got to do is you've got to repent and receive the heart of Lord Jesus Christ. When, with his death and his resurrection, he gave his heart for you and he asks you, would you like to be mine? That's all it is. And it is a proposal. You can say yes or no, but there are consequences of that. And as a human beings, we have to deal with the consequences of the decisions we make. While King of Kings steps in and then off gives you proposal, gives you his heart. If you reject that, I can't say much about it. But if you accept that proposal, you are given new heart, your mind, your heart, your brain, you are all washed away with the blood of Lord Jesus Christ. And you are his, you are declared righteous. That's all you are. That is out there. Nothing can change your identity. With that in mind, beloveds, we will see you on another live stream. I think we planned live stream tomorrow evening between Daughter of Christ and Abbas from Speaker's Corner on dress code of Aisha. Until then, be blessed, be blessings, and preach Christ crucified. God bless you all.